I'd like to share with you the greatest news in the universe. There is a God. You're not Him. The God who is exists in three persons, Father, Son, and Spirit. Not three gods, one God. Our little minds can't fully conceive, but the Bible clearly teaches that there's one God in three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And for reasons known largely only to Himself, He was pleased to spill over in creation. The Bible says He created everything for His own glory. And as a crowning display of His creative genius, He made man in His own image. Our first parents, Adam and Eve, lived in perfect fellowship with God on the day that they were created. But the Bible teaches us that instead of honoring and obeying Him, instead of enjoying and delighting in Him as they should have, which is the definition of bliss, instead of that, they rebelled against Him. They fell into sin. They took His word and disregarded Him. They tried to usurp His throne and become their own deity. And you will have nothing to do with me. You will not tell me how to run my life. That's how they sinned. Well, instead of kicking them to the lowest corner of hell, which is what they deserved, that would have been fair, God unfolded His eternal plan to send a Redeemer for sinners, that He would provide a way for these rebellious creatures to be reunited in fellowship with Him and enjoy Him forever, as we were created to do. Well, the Bible teaches very simply that the Lord Jesus Christ is that Redeemer, the second person of the Trinity, the one who from eternity has enjoyed fellowship with the Father and the Spirit, is the one who came and lived a life of obedience before the Father that you should have lived. And the reward He got for perfectly obeying the Father was we tacked Him to a tree. We took a perfectly innocent man, and as the reward for a life of perfect obedience to the Father, we crucified Him. We put the Lord of glory on a tree and said, in effect, He's too vile for us. You deal with Him. And the Bible teaches that's exactly what happened. The Lord laid on Him the iniquity of us all. God judged Him for your sin and for my sin. The Bible teaches that because Jesus is a perfect sacrifice, He could satisfy the justice of God as a sacrifice for your sin and mine that's adequate. Well, how do we know that He was enough? How do we know that God accepted His sacrifice and it didn't leave something undone? Well, the Bible teaches that 3 days later, God raised Him from the dead. And Romans chapter 4 says, I love this, He was raised for our justification, so that when God looks at you and me, if we have our hope in Christ alone for the forgiveness of our sins, and the fulfillment of all God's promises, God looks at us and says, I declare you right with me. I declare you justified in my presence. And the best part of the good news is not only what we're saved from, death and hell and the consequence of our sin, but what we're saved for. And that is the everlasting enjoyment of God, the much-making of God when He comes again and Christ establishes His kingdom, a new heavens, new earth, perfect, perfect environment with glorified saints and angels to delight in God forever. And the Bible teaches that that is the gospel, that Christ died for your sins, that He was buried, and that He was raised again on the third day. And if you would take sides with God against yourself and against your sin, and you'd put your faith in Jesus, He promises that He'll save you and He'll have you forever. Won't you have Him? Won't you turn to Him? Won't you give your life to Him? And you want to know the weight of majesty? Meet God in Christ and He'll have you forever. And you will be thrilled forever with the greatest of all delights. And That's God Himself in the person of His Son, in the power of the Holy Spirit.